your Holy Spirit speak to our hearts today. Lord, maybe there's one on the side of my voice that has received his Lord and Savior, but Father, they've just never been baptized. They've never followed you, Lord. Lord, maybe today, this service, Lord, will be something that your Holy Spirit has to show them their need and their importance of baptism. Father, we ask you to lead us and guide us to all that is said and done here. We ask you to forgive us what we said to you. Christ, we pray, we give thanks to my family, I said, with me. Amen. Thank you. Thank you.
assemblies and they're all recorded. And I don't know this one. It's like this one. Thank you.
Thank you.
If it's a Christian rite, such as baptism or the Eucharist, anybody know what the Eucharist is? That's communion. Right. The Eucharist stands for and give thanks. Okay? Why? That is believed to be ordained by Christ, and that is held to be a means of divine grace, or to be a sign of a symbol of spiritual reality. Okay? So the Eucharist, we hold that to be a sacrament, because Jesus in the upper room at the Passover did what? Instituted communion. Remember what he said? As often as you do this, you what? Do it. Remembrance of me is exactly right. So, remember, Christian rite, that is believed to have been ordained by who? Christ. Okay? So that's where we get the Eucharist or communion from. Now, where do we get baptism from? Because who? Matthew chapter 3. Okay? Jesus was what? He was baptized. Is that not right? Now, you remember when he showed up on, at the creek there where John was baptizing? Anybody remember what John the Baptist told him? I don't have the right to baptize you. You're the man that takes away the sin of the world. I want you to what? Baptize me. What did Jesus tell him? No. He said, so that everything will be fulfilled, I must be what? Baptized. So we have the example. Is that not right? Of his baptism. But more important than that, we also have his command. Okay? Matthew chapter 28. Everybody there with me? I'm saying, I put these in here, which is, I figured I wouldn't have enough time for you to turn it to them, and I figured I'd just have to read them off of you. Matthew chapter 28, look with me at verse 19. All right, so back up. All right, verse 18. Okay. Look with me at verse 18. And Jesus came and spake unto them, saying, all power is given unto me in heaven and in where? Earth. Go ye therefore and teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Now, we just witnessed that in practice. Okay? But I want you to notice something in verse 18 that is unique. Because here's the deal. Invariably, we're going to use the verses that are going to bear this point out. Invariably, our charismatic friends are in the Church of God and some of the Pentecostal folks will say, no, but Peter said to be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ. And they came to my office one time in another church and said, but I've been baptized in the name of Jesus Christ. I have my baptismal certificate here. Am I baptized? And I said, well, no. He said, my former pastor said that we should be baptized like Peter demonstrated in Acts chapter 2. All right? What's the answer to the question? All power. You know what that word power translates? That word translates into authority. In other words, church, you may confuse a lot of people. Because here's the deal, right? Every time you see that word baptized right there, translated in the New Testament from the Greek, it is baptismo, which means to completely immerse. This is why when we get into the baptism of the Holy Spirit, yes, there are several baptisms in the Bible. When we get into the baptism of the Holy Spirit, what it means is to be
biggest reason why. Because this is out of order. In other words, a living man, somebody else can do that, just my wife made me do it, just my husband made me do it, just the kids are always happy about being baptized. Because you know what? I wanted to see what it felt like. They were there and looked pretty neat. But they never repented of their sins. And because of that, hopefully before they pass, the Lord will show them they need a relationship. That will come to me and say, but I need to be baptized. I need to get my baptism on the right side of my salvation. So, there is an order to baptism. All right? Now, baptize, you didn't believe. Believe, repent, and baptize. But that's it. Now, my fingers are not clean. And I have to preach all sorts of things because I cannot. What's going on? Right. There, baptism is a symbol. Okay? Baptism does not save you. Please, if somebody asks you, don't tell them you go to the mass and say baptism washes away your sins. Tell them you go to Bible. Tell them you go somewhere else, but don't tell them you come here. The preacher here taught you that. Right. Does not wash away your sins. It does not make you in the eyes of the Lord. Because of any of those things, it absolutely is a symbol of the atonement of Christ. Now, does anybody know what atonement is? Nobody knows what atonement is. I tell you, Gene, I've thought about it this way. I wish was that other. Atonement means to pay the price for it. All right? saying, man, I don't know how long time to help people show up at church on Sunday. I said, man, I don't have any church members. And I thought to myself, man, that's the first one in my mind. I said, you know what? We don't have that kind of people down to come to church and say amen. If they're born again, we should have to be, I should have to be a child at 11 o'clock at night sitting there dating, saying, gee, when will you show up? Amen. You should be saying, hey, you know what? I want to be with God's people. I want to be where God's at. I want to be right there with them amongst them. Amen. And if you don't, you might have to ask yourself, has nothing in my life changed? And if it has not, there's a very good possibility you just don't win. You need to get baptized. Okay? So, we identify with Jesus as the in salvation. Okay? It is the simple reason why I told you of something that happened in here that we are demonstrating it to everybody, to the world, to everybody. We've said, you know what? I died to the whole way of doing things. But I didn't stay dead. I rose again to new life in Christ Jesus. And the way I live my life, the way I talk, the way I dress, the fact that I'm the kind of shoes I wear, the clothes I've got on, all of that shows you that what happened to me is real and genuine. So baptism is a simple thing. But it's also the idea that the believer submits to Jesus' authority. What he said? So therefore, at what? Baptize him. Is that all right? He said all authority was given to him. Him, is that all right? So, have you, this is why you hear people preach yourself all the time, have you been obedient to follow the Lord in believer's baptism? In other words, have you submitted to his authority and said, Lord, I'm doing what you said to me? Death, burial, and resurrection, all of which was necessary for redemption. What's that? And baptism, really important. It is important to a believer. It is not important to the world. It is not important to someone who has not repented of their sins. For somebody who has repented of their sins, guess what? They want to be obedient to what God has to say. So, a baptized, it is a genuine act of faith. Some people just get wet. You said, preacher, how do you know? All you got to do is look at somebody's life. I'm going to tell you what, you said, I'm not sure what that person did. Just look at your life. Just look at where your priorities are. And I'm going to tell you something. If your priorities are the same old, same old, you might want to ask yourself what happened when you just had a crying gasp or an emotional fit or the preacher just scared you or if you really got saved. Because there's a difference. Okay? And then we identify with the necessity of a changed life. If you identify with Jesus, your life must be changed. If it is not, then it's not true. So you're okay. Are you saved today? So, how are you saved? I joined the church. I'm in Sunday school. How do I get saved? Here's how you get saved. But I'm saved for all of sin. I'm sure the glory of God can happen. Get to God. That's your sinner. Now, preacher, you don't have to make it the preacher doesn't because I'm nobody. But I'll tell you what. You need to tell God, yes, I'm a sinner. Thank you. somebody has anybody to do. I told you, that's the whole time I was talking about that. Just like you, if you got saved when you raised your Bible down there, that thing got up and ran you through it, and we see Jesus. But the Bible says he comes to live inside of us. Is that not right? No, you can't see it. That's what we know then. We know by changed life, or we know by your profession. Yes. You know what? Romans chapter 10 says, you know what? If things that are pleasing, it will not be ashamed. You don't have a problem with the world standing up saying, guess what? But today we have to make my life's been changed forever. I tell you what's that forever scratch yet. My life's been changed for eternity. So tonight, are you saved? Think back when you got baptized. Is anything different in your life? Has your life changed at all? Maybe it was 30 years ago. Maybe it was 50 years ago. I'm not your question. Is there something different going on? Is the Holy Spirit at work inside of you? If not, maybe you just got a win. Maybe you get baptized. So maybe today, the first thing you need to do is get saved. The first thing you need to do is admit, believe, and confess. There's somebody here this morning, myself. If God gives you the courage to step out of the word of life and show you that you can have eternal life in Jesus Christ, our Lord, I can show you how to do more than just get wet. I can show you how to get baptized. But if you're new, I would encourage you to come and see you this morning, and he wants to meet with you. All you have to do is come. What number will I say? What name? What number will I say? What number will I say? Yeah, I don't want to be here. Page 385, take your name and stand with me. 285, page 285, you take me and let's stand with me. Turn to page 285 and join me as we pray. Our Father and God, as we bow in your presence, Lord, we worship you, we honor you, and praise you. Lord, we thank you for those who came today and were baptized and were obedient to you. And Father, we just pray, Lord, that you would bless them. We just pray, Father, that as they begin their new life in you, Lord, that you would walk beside them and that they would draw close to you. Lord, we pray that we as a church, Lord, would honor them by discipling them, by coming alongside of them. Lord, take it back to when we, Father, were baptized. Take it back to when we began our walk with you. Father, if there's one in the sound of my voice that doesn't have a relationship with you, Lord, if there's one person here this morning that is in danger of hellfire because they have never met you at the cross, Father, I pray, would you give them the courage to step out? Lord, that you just give them the energy they need to walk down this aisle and catch me by the hand. And Lord, just give me the energy and the courage and the strength to open the words of life and show them how they can have eternal life in Jesus Christ our Lord. Father, God, today, there are some folks here that need to get their baptism on the right side of their salvation. And Lord, we know that. Look at all of this. It's all about obedience. And today, Lord, there are some of your people that are here. Lord, maybe they were genuinely saved, maybe they were genuinely baptized, Lord. Maybe now they're living a life of disobedience. Father, I pray, Lord, that your Holy Spirit would be like a light, a light shining inside their heart. Show them the areas, Father, where they need to work on, Lord, that they need to confess, that they need to get out of their life. So that they might have that perfect fellowship with you. Father, there's one hurt me. I need to ask you to give the glory to your riches and glory. And Father, we will praise you. We will worship and honor you. Because we ask in Jesus' name before this thing. And all God's people said to me, amen. Won't you come right now?